So which is yung audit ng PPE or property, plant, and equipment. So actually, for some references, considered siya as a separate cycle. Part siya ng investing cycle. Right? So, but anyway, although may mga unique controls and procedures over accounting for PPE or property, plant, and equipment, yung acquisition sa PPE, it also goes through the purchasing cycle kasi. Okay? So, ibig sabihin plus, pag nag-purchase si company ng item of PPE, dadaan din siya sa purchasing process. So, let's just discuss the peculiarities no, ng audit ng PPE account. So, nature muna. So, PPE or property, plant, and equipment are assets used in the business of our client with expected lives of more than 1 year and not acquired for resale. Now, unlike dun sa major bulk or portion ng purchasing process, which is purchase of merchandise, yung merchandise kasi acquired for resale. Or yung raw materials, it is acquired to produce goods for resale. So, yung PPE, it will be used for the operations of the entity. So, kaya may difference yung PPE against other current assets like inventory, prepaid expenses, and even investments in terms of use and lifespan. However, end of day, yung acquisition of PPE also goes through the purchasing process of the entity or the company. Now, in audit of PPE, the primary accounting record of the client is called the PPE Master File, Fixed Asset Master File, or Schedule of Property, Plant, and Equipment, or in some companies, Fixed Asset Register. So, doon sa Fixed Asset Register na yon, or Schedule of PPE, naka-include yung all information about the PPE acquired by the entity. So, yung mga PPE acquired by the entity include class description ng equipment acquired, quantity, purchase date, useful life, and even yung acquisition cost and periodic depreciation. So usually may mga tag or unique identifier din like PPE number or ID number for that PPE. So the same information is also printed no, or included in each of the PPE item. Kaya halimbawa, yung isang PPE item, sa PPE register, meron siyang ID number na, let's say, equipment 123. So, that same information will also be included in the specific PPE item to be for the company to be able to locate it in case they will conduct an inventory count of their PPE items. Or sometimes, for some companies, they use a barcode system. So, to tag the PPE to determine its location within the entity. Now, unlike inventory or kaya cash, yung PPE class expected siya to be a low turnover account. So, yung inventory kasi or kaya yung cash, high turnover account sila. Kaya usually, in audit of PPE, what is different is that we focus on test of transaction instead of test of balances. So, kasi for audit of high turnover account, kagaya like for example, ng audit of inventory or audit of cash. Most of our assurance comes from our test of details of balances. For example, class, if we audit inventory, usually our primary audit procedure is to observe the physical observation of inventory at year end and perform test count of the inventory items. So instead of focusing on the test of purchases and this purchases and sale to validate the ending balance of inventory. Why? Kasi pa nag-focus ka sa purchases and sales transaction, it will be very tedious because there's a lot of what? Purchases and sales transactions during the year to obtain assurance on the ending balance of inventory. Kaya ano yung more efficient way? You test the inventory present at year end by attending the physical inventory count of the client. O ganun din, halimbawa, we are auditing the ending balance of cash. If we are auditing the ending balance of cash, ano yung preferred method ni auditor? To confirm the balance of cash against the bank. Instead of going from the beginning balance, and then you will audit all the cash receipts, audit all the cash disbursement, to arrive at the validated balance of cash at the end. That would be less efficient kasi you have to test more items compared if you just confirm the ending balance with the bank. So mas efficient yung test of ending balance because of what? High turnover nature of those accounts. So sa PPE opposite, more efficient if you test the transactions compared sa ending balance. Kasi yung PPE naman, low turnover. Halimbawa, so let's say you're auditing an entity like PRTC. So halimbawa, si PRTC meron siyang different locations around the country. May PRTC sa Manila, sa Davao, sa Cebu, sa Cagayan de Oro, and may mga PPE items kami. So meron kami projectors, meron kami mga chairs, may mga furniture, building for example, halimbawa ng audio building. So may mga building, so yun yung mga examples na PPE that you can audit. So yung test of balances, that means you have to be present at year end and conduct count of the PPE items, right? So bibilangin mo yung mga chairs, bibilangin mo yung projector, 1, 2. Bilangin mo yung aircon, 1, 2, 3. Yung mga furniture, yung mga computers, etc. Pagkatapos mo mabilang, yun yung iyong test of details of balances. Kukompare mo yun sa cost na nasa record, di ba? Okay? Sige, granted, you've done that. After 1 year, hinire ka ulit ng PRTC to audit your FS. So, audit mo na naman yung PPE. Pumunta ka na naman sa different location. Pumunta ka sa Manila, sa Cebu, sa Cagayan de Oro, dito sa Davao, binilang mo na naman yung upuan, only to realize kung ilan yung binilang mong upuan last year, yun din yung mabibilang mo this year. Kung ilan yung aircon last year, yun din yung aircon na nabilang mo this year. So, konti lang yung movement. Kung meron man, siguro, nadagdagan or nabawasan yung chairs ng ilang pieces, yung aircon nadagdagan ng one piece. So, therefore, practically, what you have seen last year are the same items that you audit this year. E kaya lang, more tedious yun. Kasi you went again to different locations, di ba? You spent probably a day or two inspecting those accounts only to find out minimal changes have occurred. So, less efficient if you will test the details of balances. Kaya for continuing client, what do? We focus on transactions. Kaya instead of test of details of balances, what will be our primary audit procedure for audit of PPE? More on test of acquisitions and disposal. So, pero applicable yan class kung continuing or recurring yung client. Kasi kung first time audit client, do you still need to perform detailed testing of balances like inspection of PPE items sa mga location ni company? Yes, kailangan pa rin. And then, once you have established the beginning balance, then for continuing audit engagement, you'll just focus on acquisition and disposal. But that doesn't mean you will not perform test of details of balances. So, magpa-perform ka pa rin ng test count, but not as much because you gain most of your assurance from test of acquisitions and disposal. So, that is why here are some of the audit procedures in audit of PPE. First, analytical procedures. So, with respect to our analytical procedures, these are the typical analytical procedures that we perform. With respect sa audit ng PPE, usually yung analytical procedures natin directed toward doon sa income statement accounts such as depreciation expense. Yeah, like for example, in this case, so we can compare depreciation expense over gross equipment cost with prior years. So in that case, we can identify potential misstatements in depreciation expense and in accumulated depreciation. So we can also compare accumulated depreciation over gross equipment cost with prior year to determine potential misstatement in accumulated depreciation. And we can also compare with related account, yung repairs and maintenance. Okay? Kasi any errors with repairs and maintenance could also reflect an error in the property, plant, and equipment. So yun kasi class, yung usually na i-interchange na account, especially if the company has weak control over their capitalization procedures. So, kasi class, take note ha, some expenditures related to items of PPE are not capitalizable. Now, like for example, yung mga repairs or yung mga useful maintenance. So, ano dapat yung treatment doon? Expense out or expense outright. So, si client, pag meron siyang useful repairs or maintenance activity and they include it as part of the PPE, what will happen? So, it will overstate the property, plant, and equipment. So, kaya pag si auditor, he or she suspects overstatement sa PPE, So ano yung chine-check ng account? Yung PPE account. Yung tingnan mo yung folder ng costs charged to PPE. Kasi pag may kasama doon invoices for, let's say, common repairs or common maintenance, then that means that that PPE was overstated. So kasi yung mga expenditures for maintenance should have been what? Expense outright. Okay? Okay, another example. Si client nag-install ng aircon. Let's say, split-type aircon. Eh, usually, yung service dyan to install separate dun sa pag-purchase ng aircon itself. Kaya nangyari, nung pinurchase yung aircon, may cost yung aircon. Let's say, 50,000 pesos. And then si company, nag-hire siya ng separate service provider to install the aircon who charge, let's say, 8,000 pesos for it. Yung installation cost ng aircon, what is the proper accounting treatment? Should it be capitalized or expense outright? It should be capitalized as part of the cost of the aircon. Pero what if the company inadvertently recognized it as what? Expense. So what will happen? The PPE will be understated naman. So kasi instead of i-capitalize, ang ginawa ni client, in-expense. And usually saan chinacharge yun? Sa repairs and maintenance. Okay? So that is why, in case we suspect naman that the PPE is understated, what record would be checked? The repairs and maintenance expense. Okay? Kaya kapag naging auditor tayo class, nag-iiba yung line of thinking natin eh. So mas nangingibago yung professional skepticism. Kaya halimbawa, pumunta ka sa office ni client. Pagpunta mo sa office ni client, nakita mo yung office bagong pintura. So, kung normal na person ka, ang sasabihin mo, uy, ang ganda ng office nyo ah, bagong pintura. So, that is the normal line of thinking. Pero pag auditor ka na, iba na yung line of thinking mo. Pag pumunta ka sa office ni client, nakita mo bagong pintura, ang iisipin mo, ano kayang treatment dun sa repainting cost? Baka kinapitalize ah. So, overstated ang PPE, no? Or overstated ang building. Okay? May pag may nakita kang bagong install ng aircon, pag normal person ka, sabihin mo, wow, ang lamig, bago yung aircon. Pero pag auditor ka, ano kayang accounting treatment dun sa installation cost? So baka inexpensa, dapat i-capitalize yun. Okay? So ibig sabihin na overcome ka na ng iyong professional skepticism. So yung line of thinking mo is pang-auditor na talaga. So pag ganun na yung pumapasok sa mga isip mo, di ba? Now, finally, for test of details of balances naman. So, ito may mga list tayo. And then, later on, we'll discuss yung primary procedure, yung test of acquisition and disposal. So, dito, let's look at the list lang muna of the typical audit procedures done for PPE. So, ito yung first one. Our audit objective is to determine whether the current year acquisitions in the acquisition schedule agree with the related PPE records and the total ng PPE records agree with the general ledger. So yung mga procedure natin dito class, we can verify the mathematical accuracy of the PPE ledger or PPE schedule. So again, we were discussing about the test of details of balances. First, with regard to PPE additions. So again, yung test for PPE additions, this is our primary substantive audit procedure for audit of PPE for continuing clients. So here, in the next one, next audit objective, so current year acquisitions as listed exist. So in fact, ito na yung major objective natin dito sa test of PPE addition. So sa pag-test ng acquisition or addition, yung procedure natin dito class is number one, inspection of documents. In particular, inspect natin yung invoice from supplier na nag-deliver ng item of PPE and it is done in conjunction with physical examination of asset. So once na-validate natin yung correct cost based on dun sa invoice at na-establish natin yung existence ng asset, so that will set the validity ng addition or acquisition of PPE to be included in the PPE schedule. So other audit procedures include test of completeness, so whether the existing acquisitions are recorded. So dito naman, you will start from the physical asset itself. Halimbawa, mag-identify ka ng asset in the factory or in the liquidation of the client and trace it back to the PPE ledger or pwede rin from the invoice. So sa mga invoice ni supplier, yun naman yung iyong population. So trace it to the PPE register. Next, accuracy. So you can examine vendors' invoices, recalculate the cost. So including yung mga terms like discount, installation cost, and additional cost that is required to be capitalized. Next, in this one, current year acquisitions are recorded in the correct period. So you can review transactions near balance sheet date to determine whether the transactions were recorded in the correct period. And then finally, we have a test whether the client has rights over the current year acquisition. So you can check also the invoices to determine whether the asset is really under the name of the company. So you can also examine minutes of meetings of the board of directors to determine whether items of PPE were used as collateral or securities for debt. Usually, dyan naman yun, in conjunction with test of classification then, pati test of presentation. So another concern dito class, yung for example, mga right of use asset. So you can also review lease contracts to determine whether the company should capitalize lease, especially yung mga lease term na more than 1 year. So in that case, so the entity should recognize that and disclose in the financial statement yung right of use over those lease assets. And aside from test of additions, we also have test of retirement. Yung test of retirement, nagiging issue siya class in case the client does not have a formal process for identifying assets that are retired or disclosed, right? Or disposed rather. So kasi, yung additions, easier siya to test. Kasi yung addition, it goes through the formal process. Yung addition, it goes through the purchase process of the client. So that is why it's easy to identify when there are asset addition. But it is more difficult to identify what? Disposal or retirement. Especially if the client does, if the client does not have an established control or process to report disposal of assets. So kasi halimbawa, let's say the company has a malfunctioning equipment. On the part of the production people, halimbawa nasa factory ka or nasa production site, and then there is a malfunctioning machine. So what would be the tendency of the production personnel toward that malfunctioning machine? They will just abandon it. Probably lalagay nila sa storage, lalagay nila sa isang area, and then that's it. They will just use a functioning machine. So, okay, if they were instructed na, okay, pag may sirang machine, you have to report it to your supervisor. This is supervisor instructed to report that to the management so that the management will inform the finance department. So, in that case, that's easier. That's an indication of a good internal control over retirement or disposal. So, kasi once an asset is identified to be malfunctioning or destroyed or cannot be used anymore, then the entity should dispose that asset, discard that from the books, remove that from the books, retire that from the books, or at least recognize an impairment if it will not be totally disposed. But it cannot be used the way as it's being used in the past, no? So, but for some companies, they do not have that formal method. So there are instances that there's a possibility that there are retirements or disposals that are not recorded. So in that case, that lack of formal method to report retirement or disposal could result to overstatement of the PPE. So since if it should be retired already, and it still is part of the books or part of the records of the client, then the PPE will be overstated. Or if retired, if what we call this impairment is already warranted, then the impairment is not recognized, then it will result also to overstatement of PPE. So that is why yung pag-identify ng mga formal tracking methods and internal verification can reduce yung risk of misstatement over the PPE. So kaya kailangan well-informed yung mga production staff of the procedures when they identify a malfunctioning machine. So, normally that's the case sa mga large companies, okay? Or mga sophisticated companies. Pero even some large companies or yung mga smaller companies, so they lack this formal tracking methods of malfunctioning equipment. Kasi pag production department ka, tapos may sirang machine, so di mo naman, halimbawa ikaw, you're a factory worker or production worker, may sirang machine, hindi mo naman maiisip na, ah, kailangan itong i-recognize sa books of accounts ng company. Di ba? Di mo naman maiisip yun. Unless you are instructed by your supervisor to report any malfunctioning machine to the team. Kung may formal tracking method, no problem. So that is why, pag nagsesearch tayo ng mga potential unrecorded retirement, one of our procedures is to interview production people. So kasi pag nag-interview tayo ng production people or factory personnel, we can ask them whether they have known instances of, let's say, malfunctioning equipment or abandoned equipment. And then once we have identified the abandoned or malfunctioning equipment, so we can trace the values in the books of accounts of the entity. So it's still they are recorded at full amount, so then the PPE must be overstated. So kasi they must be retired already or that naka-recognize na ng impairment loss. So in that case, we verify now whether all disposals are recorded correctly at correct amounts by gathering sufficient and appropriate evidence and conducting detailed tying tests. So especially with respect to may mga actual disposal. Halimbawa, si company, meron silang sale ng asset. Nag-sell sila ng item of PPE. Now, in many instances, the client could record or report an incorrect amount of disposal or incorrect calculation of gain or loss in recording that retirement. Kaya every time na merong retirement entry sa books, alert tayo sa mga credits in PPE account and debits in accumulated depreciation. So we try to recalculate the gain or losses. Kasi usually doon nag-a-arise yung mga material misstatements in recording the retirement. So the accuracy of the transaction will be verified by examining the sales invoice and property master file. So we double check. So whether the company has correctly retired the cost and the related accumulated depreciation in the books and properly recognized the gain or loss arising from the disposal of PPE. So we can also check whether the replacement of asset has been correctly eliminated from the records. So kasi sometimes ni-retire yung asset but it is not removed from the record. So, yung mga procedures na yun, it's called search for unrecorded disposal. So, kasi it will test no, whether the PPE is overstated by not recording those disposal. So, some examples ng search for unrecorded disposal. Yung primary procedure to test for unrecorded disposal, vouching. So, meaning to say, from the property file, sa list ng schedule of PPE, we try to locate those items in the production floor or in the premises of the client. Kasi halimbawa, nakalagay doon sa list of PPE, equipment number 123. So ang understanding natin, since it is still included in the list of PPE, it is still being used. So if we try to vouch it, locate it in the premises of the client, but we cannot see equipment 123 in the factory of the client or in the office of the client, and we ask the client, so, why is there an equipment 123 in your list of PPE but we cannot locate it in any of your premises? So, sabi niyang client, kasi yan, na-retire na siya. Halimbawa, a few years ago. So, that means that is an unrecorded retirement. So, kasi in reality, that asset pala was already sold or disposed of. Pero what happened? It's still included in the list of PPE. So that is an example of search for unrecorded retirement. Another example of search for unrecorded include review whether the entity has replaced an existing asset when they acquired a new asset. Halimbawa si client, they acquired a new equipment. So we try to ask the client, so why did you acquire a new equipment? So is it to fulfill an excess demand or is it to replace a broken asset? So kasi if it is to replace a broken asset, then that means there is an asset that should be retired or disposed from the books. Another is to analyze gains and losses of disposal of asset and miscellaneous income for receipts from the disposal of assets. So sometimes kasi si client, when they sell a PPE, they will just recognize the receipt as miscellaneous income. So the only entry that they will make in the books is debit, cash, and credit, miscellaneous income. However, that is not an appropriate way how to recognize the sale of the asset. So yung proper procedure in recording the sale of an asset or non-operating asset is to debit cash to credit the cost of the PPE, debit the related accumulated depreciation, and the difference between the net proceeds and the carrying amount should be recognized in gain or loss. Or sometimes, the client will compute the gain or loss incorrectly. Like for example, failure to update the accumulated depreciation before the sale. So many possible misstatements could occur in terms of disposal or retirement transaction. So that is why every time there is a credit to PPE or a debit to accumulated depreciation or a credit to miscellaneous income, so we try to trace the originating transaction. Kasi if it turns out to be related to a disposal of asset, so we try to determine what is the correct implication of the transaction. Kasi it could relate to an unrecorded retirement. So another, we can also review modifications in the plan or changes in the product line or changes in major costly item-related equipment, property taxes, or insurance coverage for indications also of retirement of PPE. So like for example, si client, naka-receive siya ng proceeds from non-insurance policy. So pag may proceeds from non-insurance policy, so that could be an indicator of a damaged property, no, or a lost property. So therefore, we can trace it, what is the reason for receipt of insurance proceeds. If it is related to a damaged or destroyed item of PPE, then that must be retired from the books. And finally, we also make inquiries of management and production personnel. Kasi, like we mentioned earlier, so si production personnel, they might have knowledge about items of PPE or broken items of PPE. So we ask them and trace the asset in the books of the company if they were properly retired or provided with impairment loss. So next, we verify also the ending balance of property, plant, and equipment. So although yung primary audit procedure natin is additions and disposal, we will still have to perform a test of details of ending balances on PPE balance. So in this case, our major objective in testing the ending balance of PPE would be existence, completeness, and proper measurement of PPE in accordance with the accounting standard. So yung existence and completeness, we have done that through our test of additions and disposals. So we also consider na yung nature ng internal control ni client over equipment or PPE. So to decide our audit test to meet these three major objectives. So yung mga controls include controls over the master file. So we check whether updated pa yung PPE register ni client. So do the client has controls over movable assets? Like for example, yung properly tagging the asset and monitoring their location within the company or every time a movement. So indicator yun na strong or weak control. And whether the client has a formal means of informing the accounting department if there are disposals, parting yung expected control over items of PPE. So one of our first procedures in determining or auditing the PPE is to tie up yung PPE register with the general ledger. So yung balance in the list of schedule of PPE should tie up the general ledger for property, plant, and equipment, and of course, accumulated depreciation. So we also want to perform test count. So pwede rin tayo mag-sample from the list of PPE items and vouch that dun sa floor or dun sa production area ni client or even office. Kung halimbawa, ang tinetest natin is mga office equipment. So we can perform test counts or inspection. And then finally, if the company have equipment on hand that they no longer use or idle, and they are considered material, then we evaluate whether the assets are impaired or should be classified instead as held for sale, or yung mga non-current asset held for sale. So kaya yung procedure natin is to discuss with management what is their process for recognizing impairment and what is their process in coming up with the estimates in determining impairment loss. No, kasi yung pag-recognize ng impairment, it involves significant judgment and estimate. And often, yung mga balances sa PPE, material yan. Kaya kapag warranted yung impairment loss, it can significantly affect the valuation of the asset. Eh yung, paano ba kinocompute yung impairment loss sa PPE? So, di ba, you compare the carrying amount with the recoverable amount. Eh yung recoverable amount, maraming judgment yung involved yan. Like for example, in the computation of value in use or in determining the fair value of the PPE. Because of that, pwede rin siyang source of material misstatement. So aside from the PPE, we also validate depreciation expense. For audit of depreciation expense naman, usually yung procedure natin dyan involves analytical procedures. So pero yung risk kasi dyan, yung depreciation expense, that is being determined by internal allocation, and the test of details would be required, test of details of transaction would be required if there are material depreciation expense. So other than those that we have already determined in test of controls over PPE. So especially kung yung depreciation expense, it is being used to allocate for the cost, for example, of inventory. So in case manufacturing entity si company. But as I mentioned earlier, no, yung depreciation expense, our major objective then is accuracy since it's transaction. Pero one of our major procedure dito is yung analytical procedures. So in case may mga changes then in estimate, so kailangan din makonsider yung changes in estimate to determine the correctness or appropriateness ng level of depreciation recognized by the entity. So in doing that, we perform substantive analytical procedures. Kung significant yung difference or unreasonable yung amount, so then we might have to perform further investigation as to the cause of the significant difference. So instead of analytical procedures, we can perform detailed recalculation. So in case there are significant difference from our prediction or expectation. So and then finally, we also perform evidence of presentation audit objectives. Kasi class, sa financial statements, required as part of disclosure yung lapsing schedule ng PPE. So yung roll forward ng PPE from beginning, additions, disposal, ending for both cost and accumulated depreciation. And yung depreciation expense then class, required yan to be disclosed no, sa notes to financial statements. And kung saan portion siya ng income statement na report, kung part siya ng cost of sales, na general and administrative expense or ng selling expense. So because of that, yung audit procedure natin sa depreciation expense also include audit procedures to determine proper presentation and disclosure. Finally, ending balance naman ng accumulated depreciation. So pero yung audit procedure sa accumulated depreciation, so detailed audit effort na lang yung kailangan. So kasi it's just a, or yung test natin sa ending accumulated depreciation will depend on the result of our test of depreciation expense and test of retirement. So kasi ano ba yung mga entries to sa accumulated depreciation? It will increase in case there is depreciation expense recognized during the period, and it will decrease in case there are retirements during the period. So kaya yung audit procedures natin class in verifying depreciation expense and test of retirement or disposal will be the same source of our evidence to validate the accumulated depreciation. So kaya sabi dito, so little additional testing is required anymore for ending balance of accumulated depreciation. If the transactions, like for example, depreciation expense and retirement of depreciation are already accurate no, in the property file. So yung two objectives natin in verifying ending accumulated depreciation include number one, accumulated depreciation as stated in the list of PPE or yung fixed asset register already exists with the general ledger. and the accumulated depreciation in the list of PP or master file is already accurate. So we also consider yung impact ng impairment in the balance of accumulated depreciation. Kasi in some accounting policies, di ba, yung accumulated impairment losses nire-recognize din as part of balance ng accumulated depreciation. For testing, presentation, and disclosure naman, yung audit procedures natin involve testing yung proper classification ng PPE. So, kasi sa notes to financial statements, while the PPE is reported as one-line item sa face ng balance sheet or SFP, yung breakdown of the PPE as to classes like land, equipment, buildings, vehicles, presented silang disaggregated saan? Sa notes to financial statements. So, ganun din yung case ng mga, for example, list property like right-of-use asset. So, that will already be considered when we perform test of presentation and disclosure. Finally, so yung mga assets used as security and collateral that will also be required to be disclosed separately on the FS, so chine-check din natin yung mga legal encumbrances by reading minutes of the meeting or reviewing yung mga debt contracts. So, yan. Reading the terms of loan and agreements, no, or discussion with the client or legal counsel. So, yun naman yung mga audit procedures natin with respect sa audit of PPE. Apply na natin class sa mga questions.